So this is Narpreet Kaur, who is a principal at school. And so Narpreet, why don't you give us a brief introduction of your career and what was your main motivation to become a principal?
All right.
And also, what did you study?
Yeah. See, I've done my schooling from the Convent of Jesus and Mary, Delhi. And I chose to do commerce with maths in my 11th and 12th. After which I did my English honors. I've always somehow been very inquisitive and inclined towards the English literature, which made me do my English honors. After which I did my master's in English. I got married after that, and we belong to a family where we mostly have women as teachers or principals in my family where I'm married, and my maternal family as well. So it was not really something that I'd always aspired to do initially. But then as I got married, yes, I thought that this was the best profession given the dynamics of a family.
So,
definitely it wasn't my first choice. But if I take myself back to 20 years for 25 years from now, yes, I feel that, you know, I've always been so inclined towards children. I've been too passionate about children. So my passion for my children and how much I started enjoying being with them, I've forever been a primary school teacher. I was teaching in one of the best schools in Delhi, which is called Springdale School, Dholakwa, where I almost taught for 2 decades. And then I was very lucky enough to get the opportunity of being a principal and heading a school. So I'm heading one of the pre-primary schools in Delhi, which is called Shriram Global Preschool. And I've been working over there as principal for the last 2 years. As to what you asked me, that what was the motivation for choosing this path? Initially, 20 years ago, comfort. But yes, now if you ask me, it is definitely my passion towards this profession and children both. Like I do not see myself doing anything else, even if given a choice, which is way more lucrative than what it is right now.
All right. So how do you use technology as a principal? And how do you think technology will influence how you work in the next 10 years?
See, technology, I have never been very, I always feel that I've been technologically challenged. So it is not something that comes very fluently and easily to us. So back there in my generation, it was not something that we used it so frequently. So yes, now there is no choice. And as a teacher, I didn't have to use it that much. But yes, now as a principal, I definitely had to upgrade myself and there's no other choice. But luckily, I do have people, I have a lot of people and my staff to do all this for me. But if you talk to me about technology, yes, technology plays a big vital role because there is no other way of connecting with children, with parents, with the management. And I feel that it's just made our work way more easier. It consumes us less physically and more virtually.
All right. So what guidance do you have for a student who looks to be a principal in the near future?
See, every job comes with its nuances, Johan. So one, you have to understand that you have to be very compassionate. You have to be very patient. You have to have calm and composure. Education, of course, you know, they say that most of the people are educated, but to be able to educate others is the most difficult thing to do. So teaching is not something that comes naturally. We're all learned people, but when it comes to have the patience of teaching 50 children, it genuinely takes a lot of bandwidth more than any other person. A parent sometimes is unable to control 1 or 2 children at home, but a teacher there with 50 children shows way more perseverance, way more patience than anybody else does. Yes, if you aspire to become a principal, then it has to be sheer dedication for almost, you need to have a good background and a good working, it's continuous working experience for about 10 to 15 to 20 years in reputed organizations. And that's how you grow, that's how you learn, that's how you broaden your horizons. So I think I've also learned the hard way out, and I was very fortunate enough that I got an opportunity to step up the ladder.
All right. So thank you. Thank you for your time.